for me on this card is not just the title fight between Cyborg and Holly Holm, but yeah, that one. Khabib Nurmagomedov versus Edson Barboza. Come on, son. Number two and number three in the lightweight division, which is the most stacked division, I think. It's like lightweight and welterweight are the two most stacked divisions. But it's hard to pick which one is most stacked. But Jesus Christ, I like this fight. Like this fight a lot. And apparently Nurmagomedov has a new, according to Daniel Cormier, he told me Nurmagomedov has a new conditioning guy and a new nutrition guy. And
less dessert.
No tiramisu. Just backing off the tiramisu. He's got him, you know, on a very strict diet plan, and he's far lighter than he's ever been. And we're headed into this fight. Great. This fight is in, what, 2 weeks now? The 30th?
So,
and today is
3 weeks away.
3 weeks away. So, very exciting. Very interesting. I'm fucking pumped for that fight because Barboza is one of the best strikers in the division, for sure. And Khabib can't do anything wrong on the feet because Edson can light him up, for sure. I mean, this is the best striker, for sure the best striker that Khabib has fought. He fought Michael Johnson, who's a good striker. Michael Johnson caught him and tagged him and had him rocked. It was the first time we saw any adversity whatsoever. Or any real struggle for Khabib. But he went on to dominate that fight. And he took him to the ground, just beat the shit out of him. And he's 24-0, which is unprecedented. You know, 24-0 and just been steamrolling everybody.
Mm. So, he's only like 30, right? 29, 30, something like that.
I do not know his age, but anyways, I feel like he's not even in his prime yet. What does it say here? 29. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he's like right at the door of his athletic prime.
If he can stay healthy,
prime.
I know he's had a bunch of injuries, but if he can get healthy and stay healthy, man, it's going to be scary seeing what he does.
Yeah, for Barboza, it's all about just keeping the fight standing, and Barboza has wicked leg kicks. He's the only guy in the UFC that stopped two guys with leg kicks. He stopped Rafael Oliveira with leg kicks and Mike Lulo. Both those guys he stopped with leg kicks. How do I remember that? I don't know. But his leg kicks are amongst the fastest I've ever seen in any division. His switch kick, fastest switch kick I've ever seen. It's fucking ridiculous. When he lights it up, like off that left leg, you're like, Jesus. Like, it's like he's getting there with half the time that most world-class fighters get there with that kick. So that's interesting.
Yeah, that spinning heel kick is
ridiculous.
As fast as most people's just normal head kick.
Yeah, his spinning shit's out of control. He's just a ridiculous striker. But it's all about Nurmagomedov getting him to the ground. The question is he going to be able to stuff the takedown? What's the strategy they have for this guy on the feet? Are they going to have him open up and possibly give up that takedown? Or are they going to have him cautious and just throwing punches and just constantly wary about the takedown defense? Because Nurmagomedov, he has been unchallenged when it comes to the grappling. Mm-hmm. He's so goddamn strong. It's crazy.
He's dominant.
Well, even guys like Dos Anjos, who's a black belt in jiu-jitsu, usually puts the smush on people.
Right.
You know, Nurmagomedov puts the smush on him. Yeah. He gets guys to break, too. Like, you see it in their face. They're like, fuck, I can't do anything against this guy.
Yeah. He grew up doing it to bears, so that's why.
Yeah, for real, like, legitimately. Yeah, no. Yeah.
My wife didn't believe that, so I had to pull it up and show her. And she's like, what are they doing to him?
Like, why? That's a baby. Why did they make that baby fight a bear?
He was like 6, 7, 8 years old, and a bear's just biting him in the arm.
Yeah, Jimmy Rivera versus John Lineker. That's a fucking great fight, too. That's up in the right-hand corner there.
Ooh, that's going to be good.
That's a good fight. That's a real good fight. Jimmy Rivera has looked insanely good at 135, especially that victory over Uriah Faber. I was super impressed with that. I was like, wow, like this guy is for real. I knew it was for real before, but Rivera was supposed to be fighting Dominic Cruz, but Dominic Cruz broke his arm in training. And so now he's fighting John Lineker, who's a scary fucking guy at 135.
Yeah, like